We all are generally aware of paper, pencil test, assessment methods where learners write answers, those are checked, or they submit assignments and the evaluation is done. When it comes to skills, when it comes to complete training programs, then the evaluation changes. It's not only about one question answer paper or one assignment or one project. There can be many levels of evaluation through which we wish to evaluate the entire training program or impact of that training. So this impact evaluation is also very important, particularly in industries, particularly when long-term training is done and when we want to see what and how that training is impacted. Let us see. For this, Kirkpatrick has given a model of evaluation. We will today discuss that model of evaluation. We will see why we require to evaluate training programs, what kind of model Donald Kirkpatrick has given for this kind of evaluation, and what are various levels in his model which are available with us for training evaluation. Let us see objectives of this particular session. At the end of this session, you will be able to identify the evaluation tools needed for Kirkpatrick model. You will be able to explain the use of Kirkpatrick model in industries. Now let us take a scenario. An insurance company held a rigorous training for their agents for a month. It consisted of workshop conducted by experts in the field, role play experiences with people acting as prospective clients and unsatisfied customers. The training also gave them inputs on personality development, new policies, their details and benefits. You being an instructional designer are to evaluate this training program. Think about what will you evaluate and how will you evaluate. Now, do you think simple paper pencil tests are going to be useful? Do you think their one-time presentations are going to be useful? We need to first establish, need to evaluate this kind of training programs. So many companies have their own departments for training their employees. Even training goes on in the field of education, for example, in-service training programs. A lot of expenses being incurred in such training. Evaluation of these trainings is also very important because if we don't understand impact of this kind of training program, then we really cannot decide whether to go on spending money, cost and even personnel time on such training programs. So we need to check effectiveness of these trainings. And as I said, just by one test, one interview, one assignment, we cannot really test effectiveness of these training programs. When we say that the training was really useful because there are many changes which happened after the training, then we can really establish effectiveness of such training programs. So we need to use several different methods and models for such training evaluation. As I mentioned earlier, Donald Kirkpatrick, a professor in the University of Wisconsin, put forth his idea about evaluation of such training programs. He proposed a four-step model way back in 1975. This model checks if the training program effectively accomplished all its stated goals. And this model is most widely accepted model in leading training institutions for training evaluation. If we understand this model, we can certainly implement this model wherever educational training programs are also being conducted. So let's understand this model first. There are four levels in this model: reaction, learning, behavior, and results. To understand this model, we need to first understand all these four levels. What are these levels? Reaction level of this model measures how learners reacted to the entire training program. Learning level decides and measures what kind of learning happened, what learners exactly learned from this training program. Only reaction and learning is not important. How behavior changed, how learners applied their learning into their behavior can be tested at behavior level. And most importantly, whether this kind of training program is achieving any result in that particular organization can also be measured at result level. Let's see these levels in detail in the next module. Thank you.